It is not noon. The sunbow's rays still arch the torrent with the many hues of heaven and roll the sheeted silver's waving column over the crag's headlong perpendicular and fling its lines of foaming light along and to and fro like the pale courser's tail, the giant steed to be bestrode by death as told in the apocalypse. No eyes but mine now drink this sight of loveliness. I should be sole in this sweet solitude, and with the spirit of the place divide the homage of these waters. I will call her. Beautiful spirit, with thy hair of light and dazzling eyes of glory, in whose form the charms of earth's least mortal daughters grow to an unearthly stature in an essence of purer elements. Beautiful spirit, in thy calm, clear brow, wherein is glassed serenity of soul, which of itself shows immortality. I read that thou wilt pardon to a son of earth whom the abstruser powers permit at times to commune with them, if that he avail him of his spells to call thee thus and gaze on thee a moment.
Son of earth, I know thee and the powers which give thee power. I know thee for a man of many thoughts and deeds of good and ill, extreme in both, fatal and fated in thy sufferings. I have expected this. What wouldst thou with me?
To look upon thy beauty, nothing further. The face of the earth hath maddened me, and I take refuge in her mysteries and pierce to the abodes of those who govern her, but they can nothing aid me. I have sought from them what they could not bestow, and now I search no further.
What could be the quest which is not in the power of the most powerful, the rulers of the invisible?
A boon. But why should I repeat it? It were in vain.
I know not that. Let thy lips utter it.
Well, though it torture me, 'tis but the same. My pang shall find a voice. From my youth upwards, my spirit walked not with the souls of men, nor looked upon the earth with human eyes. The thirst of their ambition was not mine. The aim of their existence was not mine. My joys, my griefs, my passions, and my powers made me a stranger. Though I wore the form, I had no sympathy with breathing flesh. My joy was in the wilderness, to breathe the difficult air of the iced mountain's top, where the birds dare not build, nor insects wing, flit o'er the herbless granite, or to plunge into a torrent and to roll along on the swift whirl of the new breaking wave of river, stream, or ocean in their flow. In these, my early strength exulted, or to follow through the night the moving moon, the stars in their development, or catch the dazzling lightnings till my eyes grew dim, or to look, listening, on the scattered leaves while autumn winds were at their evening song. These were my pastimes, and to be alone, yet there was one.
Spare not thyself. Proceed.
She was like me in lineaments. Her eyes, her hair, her features, all to the very tone even of her voice, they said, were like to mine, but softened all, and tempered into beauty. She had the same lone thoughts and wanderings, the quest of hidden knowledge, and a mind to comprehend the universe. Nor these alone, but with them gentler powers than mine. Pity and smiles and tears, which I had not, and tenderness, but that I had for her. Humility, and that I never had. Her faults were mine. Her virtues were her own. I loved her and destroyed her.
With thy hand?
Not with my hand, but heart, which broke her heart. It gazed on mine and withered. I have shed blood, but not hers. And yet her blood was shed. I saw, but could not stanch it.
And for this, a being of the race thou dost despise, the order which thine own would rise above, mingling with us and ours, thou dost forego the gifts of our great knowledge, and shrink'st back to recreant mortality. Away!
Daughter of air, I tell thee, since that hour my solitude is solitude no more, but peopled with the Furies, I have prayed for madness as a blessing. 'Tis denied me. I have affronted death, but in the war of elements, the waters shrunk from me, and fatal things passed harmless. The cold hand of an all-pitiless demon held me back. I plunged amidst mankind. Forgetfulness I sought in all save where 'tis to be found. And that I have to learn. My sciences, my long-pursued and superhuman art is mortal here. I dwell in myself and live forever.
It may be that I can aid thee.
Thy power must wake the dead or lay me low with them. Do so in any shape, in any hour, with any torture, so it be the last.
That is not in my province. But if thou wilt swear obedience to my will and do my bidding, it may help thee to thy wishes.
I will not swear. Obey? And whom? The spirits whose presence I command and be the slave of those who serve me? Never.
Is this all? Hast thou no gentler answer? Yet bethink thee, and pause ere thou rejectest.
I have said it.
Enough. I may retire then. Say!
Retire. We are the fools of time and terror. Days steal on us and steal from us. Yet we live, loathing our life and dreading still to die. I have one resource still in my science. I can call the dead and ask them what it is we dread to be. The sternest answer can be but the grave, and that is nothing. If I had never lived, that which I love had still been living. Had I never loved, that which I love would still be beautiful, happy, and giving happiness. What is she? What is she now? A sufferer for my sins? A thing I dare not think upon. Or nothing. Until this hour, I never shrunk to gaze on spirit, good or evil. Now I tremble, but I can act even what I most abhor, and champion human fears. The night approaches. Thou most rash and fatal wretch, bow down and worship. Tremble and obey. I know it, and yet ye see, I kneel not. Hence, avaunt, he's mine.
What wouldst thou?
Thou canst not reply to me. Call up the dead. My question is for them.
Great Arimanes, doth thy will avouch the wishes of this mortal?
Yea.
Whom wouldst thou uncharnel?
One without a tomb. Call up Astarte.
Shadow or spirit, whatever thou art, which still doth inherit the whole or a part of the form of thy birth, of the mould of thy clay which returned to the earth, reappear to the day, bear what thou borest, the heart and the form, and the aspect thou warest. Redeem from the worm. Appear. 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 Who sent thee there? Requires thee here.
Can this be death? There's bloom upon her cheek, but now I see it is no living hue, but a strange hectic, like the unnatural red which autumn plants upon the perished leaf. It is the same, O God, that I should dread to look upon the same Astarte. No, I cannot speak to her, but bid her speak, forgive me or condemn me.
By the power which hath broken the grave which enthralled thee, speak to him who hath spoken, or those who have called thee.
She is silent, and in that silence I am more than answered.
My power extends no further. Prince of Air, it rests with thee alone. Command her voice. Spirit, obey that scepter. Silent still. She is not of our order, but belongs to the other powers. Mortal, thy quest is vain, and we are baffled also.
Hear me, hear me. Astarte, my beloved, speak to me. I have so much endured, so much endured. Look on me. The grave hath not changed thee more than I am changed for thee. Thou lovest me too much as I love thee. We were not made to torture thus each other, though it were the deadliest sin to love as we have loved. S- say that thou loathest me not, that I do bear this punishment for both, that thou wilt be one of the blessed, and that I shall die. For hitherto all hateful things conspire to bind me in existence, in a life which makes me shrink from immortality, a future like the past. I cannot rest. I know not what I ask, nor what I seek. I feel but what thou art, and what I am. And I would hear yet once, before I perish, the voice which was my music speak to me. Called on thee in the still night, startled the slumbering birds from the hushed boughs, and woke the mountain wolves, and made the caves acquainted with thy vainly echoed name, which answered me, many things answered me, spirits and men, but thou wert silent all. Yet speak to me. I have outwatched the stars and gazed o'er heaven in vain in search of thee. Speak to me. I have wandered o'er the earth and never found thy likeness. Speak to me. Look on the fiends around. They feel for me. I fear them not and feel for thee alone. Speak to me. Though it be in wrath, but say, I reck not what, but let me hear thee once, this once, once more.
Manfred.
Say on, say on. I live but in the sound. It is thy voice.
Manfred, tomorrow ends thine earthly ills. Farewell.
Yet one word more. Am I forgiven?
Farewell.
Say, shall we meet again?
Farewell.
One word for mercy. Say thou lovest me. Thou wilt, and for the grace accorded, I now depart a debtor. Fare thee well.